I can tell that you think it is strange to live alone. And I suppose I would have to explain it from my childhood. Growing up with five other brothers and sisters, sharing a bedroom with my sister, can't wait to get away from it all, and I have, it's turned out, lived a totally different life than my family. All my brothers and sisters are married with children. I decided I did not want to get married. I knew I did not want to have children. And so I took a different route. Now, the first thing I did when I left home is I went to live in a big house in San Francisco, hippie days. Had my own room for the first time in my life and loved it. I remember my roommate saying, "Connie, your room is set up like you're expecting your parents to come see it." But it was the first time that I could have things the way I wanted. I remember, this might sound silly, but I could put a pair of scissors down and come back a week later and they were still there. Totally different from the way I grew up as a child, okay, in a madhouse. So I would say I kept on searching for that. Now, you may be able to tell from how I am that I am an outgoing, energetic, friendly person. So I have traveled all over the world. I've lived in Europe before, 40 years ago, lived in California by myself, lived in Texas, lived in Hawaii. But interestingly enough, in Hawaii, I lived in a commune. So totally opposite. There were about 30 of us at one point. Finally came down to about 10 different people left or whatever. And it was an interesting group living situation. And there were many good things about it, like having a family or having children, but not being married to any of the men. And they weren't my children, but I was able to help raise them and educate them. My forte was teaching them manners, interestingly enough. Nobody else cared about that. So anyway, that came to an end about 3 years ago. I left and was delighted to be able to go and live in a place by myself in Hawaii and buy everything I wanted for me and just have it the way I wanted. So let's see. Wherever I go, I have friends, and I think that is what worked for me after the 25-year relationship when I left, and this is a group relationship, is that I had many women friends, and men friends, but women friends for sure. And I really do believe that having women friends is what you need. The men in our lives come and go, but the women friends stay. They do, and they help you get through the... They help you get through the difficult times. So I would always call one of them, "Hey, you want to go get a drink? You want to go walk on the beach?" And so I have a confidence in myself that if I don't want to be alone, I don't have to. If I want to be alone, yay, I can, you know? I can get Netflix streaming, so I watch movies. I get DVDs from the library. I read a lot. And so... coming to Italy was not a, it wasn't a scary thing to come by myself. Some people say it was very brave, perhaps. I mean, I left all my friends in Hawaii. I sold everything I had, came with two small carry-on suitcases, and said, "Okay, it's a new life. What are we going to do here?" And, now that I've been here almost 3 years, I can say I know I came to see new things. I came to meet new people. I came to have a different view and understanding than I had in Hawaii. And 25 years is a long time in one place. Well, it is for me anyway. And so the first thing I did was go to a language exchange and meet these people from all over. One of my good friends is from Poland. There's people from Hungary, I have a Turkish friend. Our group now, we have people from Algeria. We have people from Colombia. I love being around people from everywhere. I guess I would say I'm a traveler. And maybe as a traveler, you are alone a lot, but you're also always meeting people. So I did the same thing in Pesaro. You know, I went to the language exchange through our friend Roberto, and my best friends now live in Pesaro, although I have really good friends from Senegalia. We get together all the time too. So there's a real ease and independence that I like living by myself. You know, I don't have to be always checking with somebody else, you know, okay, if I have some friends over or I'm not going to be home tonight. None of that. I have lived with some people here in Italy, with three other women in Marzocca, Monte Marciano, for a summer. And that was wonderful. And one of the gals and I are best friends now, so we still stay in touch. So the question I guess you have is, you know, how do I live with the loneliness? I just don't have it. I don't have loneliness. If you've ever tried living by yourself, I recommend it. You can sleep in the morning till noon. Sometimes I do. I wake up at 9, I say, no, I'm not ready to get up. I go back to sleep and it's 12 o'clock. Oh my God. Oh well, who cares? It's only me. And I can shop for myself and get my own food, cook up a bunch of soup. I can have friends for dinner. I actually have had friends for dinner here, 6 or 7 people. I can come home after being with friends and say, oh, that was nice. Now crawl into bed and read a book till 2 in the morning if I want. So I don't know. It's a pretty easy life. As a foreigner living here, I have a low profile. You know, I'm not out protesting things or complaining in letters to the newspaper about different things. In a way, it's nice because I don't really have to pay attention so much. I don't have to follow everything that Renzi does, although I do support civil unions. And I think we have to take care of the refugees coming. And I follow what's going on in American politics and all that, but I'm kind of on the fringe of society, and I like that. I like being there. So, anyway, that's my life. It works really well for me, and I'm very happy. So you want to talk about love, because you think that I live alone and I don't have love. I tell you a story. I used to live in Australia, and I wanted to learn how to do a particular kind of needlework, and I got involved with this guild. And we all met at this woman's house to work on a patchwork. I was learning patchwork. And I was the youngest person there. I was probably 27 at the time. And there were all these women who were married with families, and we were meeting in the home of a woman who was not married, who wasn't what they would call in Australia an old maid or a spinster. You probably have this similar name in Italian. And so she was filling her life with needlework, and she left the room and they said, yeah, she's never been married, but she has a very full life. And it was so condescending and so pitiful, I'll never forget it. But that isn't me, because I'm not an old maid. Because I haven't been married doesn't mean I haven't had many love affairs and many lovers. I have been fortunate enough to have been loved by several really good men in my life. There is a man that I love right now who actually lives in Hawaii. Is not my man, but we love each other. So my life has been filled with love. I have a loving family. Those brothers and sisters now are very close to me. So I haven't been alone in that sense. And so a lot of that, though, is pressure you have as a young person, and maybe that's where you come from, where you're thinking, I've got to have a mate, I've got to get married, I've got to start a family. And where I lived in California, you could always find somebody to be with if you wanted to have sex, for sure, or be friends with, and you didn't have to marry them and start a family to do that. So, I had several lovers in Hawaii after I left that communal family, and that was wonderful. That was really wonderful. So, I'm not looking for a man. I guess maybe I'm one of those very selfish women who's really prefer not to be a wife. I don't want to pick up my husband's underwear off the floor. I don't want to have to take care of a man. So I never wanted to be a wife. I actually had more fun being the mistress, the other woman. I know it's terrible, but that was many, many years ago when I was younger. So I'm not looking for my other half, as people say, to be fulfilled and feel a woman. I've had wonderful love and wonderful sex in my life. Now, I'm not looking for a husband in Italy, absolutely not. I'm not looking for a boyfriend. I wouldn't mind a lover. My friends in Hawaii keep saying, have you gone to bed with an Italian? And I don't know why, but I haven't. I can't find one for some reason. So I have to find an Italian lover before I leave Italy and go back to America. But that's my only prerequisite, a lover. Certainly not anything too emotional or too attached. So from those experiences, I have wonderful memories. You know, it isn't like I'm still waiting to find a man. I have found many good men. And for one reason or another, moved on. You know, sometimes my ideas, sometimes theirs. The ones that left me, I say thank you because that caused me to go another direction. What if I'd stayed with them all these years? My God. So, I've been very lucky. I've had really good men in my life. I've had really good women friends. I have a very supportive family, brothers and sisters, even my mother. So, I'm not searching for that where maybe younger people might be. I know some young people here who, you know, they feel, oh, they don't have a man. They feel less than a human being. That's terrible. So they don't have that man. There's another one out there, and there's another one out there. That's how I think of it. So don't worry about me in the love department. I have been loved, and I have loved.